We finished our electric motor, okay, and today we are going to solve some questions related to electric motor. And I sent you a picture. I sent you this picture on WhatsApp. So you can also download this picture and you can understand how motors rotate. Okay, I sent you this picture. Now we are going to learn some questions. That what is Fleming's left hand rule? So we have Fleming's left hand rule, and we studied about the left hand rule of Fleming. Okay, this was the left hand rule of Fleming. Okay, so you have to use these three fingers, and these three fingers are indicating different directions, and these are known as rule of Fleming. Okay, so this is left hand rule of Fleming. Okay, so if this is our question, that state Fleming's left hand rule. So what is Fleming's left hand rule? This is Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, this is Fleming's left hand rule. We studied this about that thumb indicates the direction of force. Thumb indicating the direction of force, and your first finger indicate the direction of magnetic field, and your middle finger indicates the direction of current. So this is, we studied about that thumb is force. And one more thing I want to tell you, that this is Fleming's left hand rule. And in Fleming's left hand rule, you will be provided with these two things always. You will be provided with, first of all, you have to find out the direction of magnetic field line. You will be provided with, okay, the direction of magnetic field lines. Okay, you will be provided with two things. Magnetic field line, we are doing some questions that what is Fleming's left hand rule. So if this is, you have to write this Fleming's left hand rule. First of all, that the thumb indicates force, the first finger indicates magnetic field lines, direction of magnetic field lines, and the magnet and the middle finger indicates the direction of current. Okay, so you will be provided with two things in this Fleming left hand rule. You have to find one thing, and you have to find the direction of force. Okay, you have to find it, and you will be provided with two things: magnetic field line and direction of current. Okay, these two things will be provided to you always in this left hand rule. These things will be provided to you. These are fingers, okay? Fingers, the directions of fingers will be provided to you. The magnetic field lines will be always north to south outside, so it will be provided to you, and the direction of current will be provided to you. One thing you have to find out, that is force. Okay, so only one thing, that is force, will you have to answer, or you have to find out. This is the Fleming's left hand rule. The second rule is, what is the principle of electric motor? Okay, so we studied about this electric motor. Okay, then in this whole line we provided about electric motor, and one thing, the principle of electric motor is, that there are fan, okay, there are washing machines, there are mixer grinders, okay, all these things are useful, okay, useful to us, and in all these things which rotates by electricity, okay, these all things are made up of electric motor. फैन और वॉशिंग मशीन और मिक्सर ग्राइंडर ऑल आर नोन एज इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर. सो एज अवर फोन अवर फैन रोटेट्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट दिस फोन इज मेड अप ऑफ सेम थिंग इन दिस फैन इज मेड अप ऑफ सेम थिंग एंड इन दिस फैन ओके this type of motor is present in our phone. So this is armature, you can see this is the armature and two magnets are fixed in this side and electricity is provided. So our fan is made up of same thing, fan. Okay, this is armature, these are that split rings. Okay, so this is the concept of our fan, this is the concept of our washing machine, and this is the concept of our mixer grinder. So all fan and mixer grinders and washing machines take same rotation like this, all of them take same rotation like this, all of them rotate in such a same manner, they rotate like this. Okay, we can see how our fan rotate, we can see how our mixer grinder rotate, and we can see how our washing machine rotate. So all thing rotate, but there is huge speed, and we can see our fan rotates, our mixer grinder rotates. Okay, it will rotate, it will take one complete rotation in 1 second, approximately one rotation in 1 second. Okay, so its speed is very high, but the basic thing is same, that all of them are electric motor. Either our fan is type of electric motor, or our washing machine is a type of electric motor, or our mixer grinder is a type of electric motor, and they rotate in such a same way, by same, all of them are having this armature and having this magnet. Okay, and electricity is provided by us. Okay, we provide electricity to our phone, we provide electricity to our fan, sorry, I don't know why I'm speaking this phone one again and again. So we provide electricity to fan, we provide electricity to washing machine, and we provide electricity to mixer grinders. So all of them, we use this same concept. And check your phone, I have sent the notes of this chapter and acid base and salt chapter. Okay, so these are our magnets. So both, all our fan, our mixer grinders, and our washing machine, all of are made up of same thing, and electricity is provided by us. We provide electricity, but all of them are provided. In fan, there is magnet and these armature. Okay, in fan we are having magnet and armature. Okay, in washing machine or in our mixer grinder, we have this armature and we have this armature. Okay, so just we provide electricity. In this case, we are using this battery, but in our households, we use electric current. Okay, we use electric current to continue the current. Okay, other than this, just think that this is electric current and this is a wire and we use socket, okay, and we provide electricity. Other than this, our fan, our mixer grinders and our washing machines and everything we rotate by using electricity are generally electric motors. Okay, so all of them are electric motors. Okay, first thing. So what does an electric motor do? Okay, so the electric motor, okay, the electric motor, what we do, that we provide electricity, and by the electricity, this armature, okay, this rotates. So as this armature rotates, we studied that how armature rotates. Once there is a stoppage of electricity, and again electricity start. Okay, so armature rotates, but as armature rotates, the fan rotates, the washing machine rotates, the mixer grinder rotates. Okay, so this rotation creates something. Okay, so in this concept, in the concept of this motor, electric motor, okay, the force creates by its own. Okay, we are just giving two things. One thing we are giving its magnetic field. Okay, this is the direction of magnetic field and this is the direction of electric current. So we are doing two things and it rotates by its own. So force is created and it rotates. Okay, force is created and rotates. But in the principle, okay, in the principle of principle of electric motor. Okay, we provide electricity. Okay, and we provide electricity, and the armature rotates. Okay, armature rotates. Okay, so we are actually converting electrical energy to mechanical energy. Okay, so what is this mechanical energy? The mechanical energy is something which is related to machine. Okay, so we are providing electricity, and by providing electricity, there is a working of machine. Okay, we are providing electricity, and by providing this electricity, this machine rotates, or our fan rotates, or our washing machine rotates, or our mixer grinder rotates. So as this armature rotates, whole machine is rotates. So by providing electricity, we makes able a machine to work. Okay, so we are converting electric energy to mechanical energy. Electrical energy to mechanical energy. Okay, so this is the working process of our electric motor. This is the working process of electric motor, that we are providing electricity. So electric energy is converting to mechanical energy. Okay, this is principle. Now, what is the role of split ring in electric motor? Split ring. Do you know about this split ring? I told you this is split ring. Okay, and each and every time this split ring changes its position. Okay, this split ring is this type. In this case, this is the split part, and in this case, it is this side, and this is the splitted part. Okay, let me tell you with another color. In this case, this is the split part. Okay, and you can see split part is changing its position, and in this case, this is the splitted part. Okay, so what does split ring do? Okay, so the split ring, what can split ring do? We know that this is, as the split ring move, okay, it will also move, and by the moving of this split ring, we studied this, okay, that this is our A, this was our A, this was our B, this was our C, and this was our D, and by a movement of this split ring, A comes here, B comes here, C comes here, and D comes here. By just splitting, we know that how, by just moving of this splitting, we know that how this splitting moves. Okay, so as this splitting moves, these armature changes its position. Okay, first A was here and now A is here. So by the help of a splitting, armature rotates. Okay, armature only rotates by help of this. Okay, so armature rotates only by help of this, otherwise it will be not able to, this armature will be not able to rotate. So this armature rotates by this split ring. Okay, this armature rotates, and it rotates, so it will help to conduct the electricity. Okay, and the direction of electricity maintain. Okay, so how the splittering moves and how this splittering helps to move this armature, how this splittering helps to move the armature and how this splittering helps to change the position of this armature, and also splittering allows the conduction of electric current. Okay, only by the help of this splittering the electric current can move throughout the armature. Okay, so this is our question. Now I am starting a new chapter which is known as electromagnetic induction. Okay. Now, what is electromagnetic induction? Till now, we have studied one thing. That we are using electricity to produce magnet. We studied this, didn't we? We studied this thing till today. We studied two things. Okay, we studied this thing that how to buy this conductor. Okay, buy this thing. Okay, each and every time by using this straight conductor. Okay, we made this electromagnet. Okay, we used electricity, we passed electricity, and we made this. We used electricity to make this magnet. And when we made this conductor a magnet, okay, the magnetic field lines come, and we know that this is a electromagnet. Okay, what is electromagnet? Metal plus electricity. Metal plus electricity is known as electromagnet. Okay, metal plus electricity is known as electromagnet. So each and every time we are using metal and we are using electricity to produce a magnet, each and every time our main option or our main work or our main focus was on to produce magnet. So each and every time by using this, we made a straight electromagnet, okay, because this thing is electromagnet. This is not more a wire, because on a simple wire, there is not an aggregate of iron, but as this is electromagnet, there is an aggregation of iron. Okay. And we did this. We also made this electromagnet. This is our circular electromagnet, and it will create magnetic effect. And by magnetic effect, we can see that there will be magnetic field lines. Okay, so definitely we are converting simple metal to magnet or electromagnet. Or the last but not the least, this thing, okay. So what we are doing here, we are just making magnets by use of electricity. We are doing this thing. In this case, this is our solenoid. Okay, and we made this magnet also. We made this electromagnet. Okay. So we did this. I'm exiting now. Can you join me just after 2 minutes? Because I think there is some problem. Okay, join me after 2 minutes.